Hey.
What? Thanks again for the ride.
I can't believe this.
Hey, Manny. Yeah. Dana and I are paddling way in the marina. We need a ride.
It's a total loss.
We're carpooling. Yeah, isn't it cute? Until Dana's car caught on fire.
No, it's not my car. It's Greg's.
It's McCormick's? Oh, that's beautiful. Talk about your unconscious hostile acts.
You think I did this on purpose?
Oh, come on. He's your boyfriend. He's not your boyfriend. Was it this week?
Well, you know, we're together. We're just not exclusive.
See? Ah, good point. Manny says fire is a very sexual metaphor. You might as well torch his...
Just get your ass down here. Look, it may be okay with you, but it's just not my style.
What happened?
Glenn hit on one of the firemen.
All right.
Mm-mm. You don't see a problem giving your number to a total stranger.
Why? I saw everything I needed to know. Well, almost everything.
Yes.
Hello. Is this the Glenn Hall Agency?
That's right. How can we help you, sir?
Well, I was hoping that you could help me find my wife's heart. We would have been married 5 years last month. The 22nd. From the moment we met, we never spent a day apart. You know, I never thought I would ever meet someone like Annie. We talked about having kids. It was a drunk driver. She never saw it coming.
I notice you still wear your ring.
Oh, habit, I guess. My therapist says I'm not ready to accept her being gone. He's right. Some nights I wake up and I could swear she's lying next to me. Maybe she is. Oh, I know. Sounds crazy.
Not at all.
I never even knew she'd signed a donor card. All the hospital would tell me was that her heart went to a 45-year-old woman living somewhere in Southern California.
And you want us to find this woman?
Whatever your fee, I'll have no trouble paying it.
Dr. Gordon, if you don't mind my asking, what do you hope to accomplish by meeting this woman?
I guess I just need to know that Annie, I mean, her heart, is in a good place. Somehow, I think it would help me to move on.
Advice, Kevin? Move on.
But I love Susan, and I'm pretty sure she loves me.
And that's why you called us. You want to know for sure.
Let me cut to the chase here. Save you a few bucks. You asked her to marry you. She said she needed time to think about it, and you're wondering if maybe she's got something going on the side.
Well, yeah.
My experience, Kevin, if you think something's going on, it's probably going on.
Has Susan ever given you a reason not to trust her?
No. I just don't know why she needed time to think about her answer. We've been together 2 years.
Listen to your gut.
Look, Mr. Wallace, you're feeling vulnerable. You're questioning everything. Let us provide some answers.
You ask me, it's kind of creepy.
How could you think that? Philip's love for Annie transcends even death. It's poetic.
It's gross. He's searching for an organ.
Glenn, it's not just an organ. It's her heart. It represents the spiritual bond they felt for each other. I only hope I can share that feeling with someone in my lifetime.
Thank you, Leonard Kirshner. May you rest in peace.
Who's Leonard Kirshner?
Former client. He needed a liver transplant, and we wanted to know what his chances were. So we hacked into WOTA. It's the Worldwide Organ Transplant Agency. They're the ones who determine who the next recipient should be.
So he didn't make it, huh?
No. You got a new liver. 2 months later, he was hit by a beer truck.
Talk about irony.
Okay, so what was the exact date Annie Gordon died?
December 17th, 1998.
And there you have it. Two heart transplants were performed in Los Angeles County on that date, a 62-year-old male in St. Vincent's and a 45-year-old female at Brentwood Memorial. Alicia Spitz.
Dana!
Uh-oh.
Came as soon as I heard. What happened?
I don't know. It started smoking, and then I pulled over, and the next thing I knew, it was in flames. I'm sorry.
Oh, I don't believe this. Did you keep coolant in it?
Greg, I had the car for 5 days. You never said anything about coolant.
I worked for 6 months restoring that car. I love that car.
By the way, I'm okay. Thanks for asking.
Yeah, me too.
I knew you were okay.
Yeah.
I checked. Look, is it a total loss?
Yes, Greg. It's a total loss. Much like our relationship.
What? Was this my fault?
Oh, in so many ways.
What?
She lives in the Pacific Palisades. We'll pay her a visit if you like.
I would. Then, if you could arrange for us to meet.
Dr. Gordon, we take all kinds of cases, but this one is a little different.
You think I'm crazy?
Well, there's an office pool. We're taking bets.
I go to the cemetery, you know, to visit her. Mm-hmm. But I feel she's not there. To think of her underground in that box without her heart. If I could meet the one, it would give me closure. That's all I want. Closure, Miss Plant.
No, it isn't. You want to believe that your wife lives on? You want
to... That isn't it.
She's dead, Philip. We'll find the woman who has her heart and we'll arrange for you to meet. But your wife is dead.
You know what you never hear anymore? Two people falling in love and living happily ever after.
You do with a good prenup.
My parents knew each other from the neighborhood. They were married 42 years, Roberta.
Sure neither one of them were getting a little something on the side?
Hey, that's what my parents were talking about.
Sure.
Need a close-up?
Those are for me. I got it.
Look, Manny, Lynn's had me offer myself up to plenty of men to test their fidelity. Some of them pass with flying colors.
Yeah, and some go down without a fight. Pardon the expression.
Well, my charms are considerable.
Roberta, let's trace this call. You getting this?
Yeah.
She's calling her mother.
Henry.
Macaroni and cheese.
You know you love it. Come on, Henry. You don't like tuna fish?
No matter how ugly the view of romance can get from this job, I still believe I'll find my happily ever after.
Yeah, well, I still have my doubts.
Fine. Go out and catch a mouse. Go on. Henry, do you know there are millions of cats starving in India?
She's actually a very good cook.
You ate her food.
I got hungry bug in the place.
Mm-hmm.
Straight face.
while I cry. Come on, Manny, please, let's go home.
In a minute.
The woman's as pure as the driven snow. We've gone through her credit cards, her phone calls, her email. She don't even cheat on her taxes. Kevin should consider himself a very lucky man.
Come on. Yeah, I know.
Come on. I thought you'd be happy about this. We finally found an innocent one.
Well, go ahead if you want. I'm right behind you.
Fine.
If I listen long enough to you,
Henry,
I'd find a way to believe that it's all true.
Looks like this woman's making the most of her second chance.
And the most of her marriage with the late Mr. Spitz. Look, keep in mind, no matter how badly Philip wants to meet her, it's still her call.
Fine.
And for the record, I still think this is sick.
What am I supposed to say to the guy? Sorry your wife's dead? I'm not sorry. The day his wife kissed that Range Rover was the first day of the rest of my life.
Miss Spitz, Philip is a good man. He's just trying to get on with his life, get a little peace.
Oh, sweetheart, you cannot be that naive. He's after my money.
Philip Gordon is a doctor of veterinary medicine. He owns three animal hospitals on the west side. He's not after your money.
We're aware you recently lost a husband. I would think you'd understand.
Fine. I'll meet with him, but if he starts weeping about his dead wife, I may puke.
Nice.
I hate to see Philip get hurt here.
It's what he paid us for, Dana. He wanted to meet the woman who got his wife's heart. He didn't say she had to be perfect.
Glenn, the man is going through the grieving process. We're about to introduce him to the Antichrist.
He's a big boy. He can handle it.
I don't know.
Miss Hall, wonderful to see you again.
Marie, ça va?
Bien et vous?
Yeah, Ben.
Right, this way.
Speaking of big boys, and I mentioned I saw Fireman Eric last night.
Can I spare me the details?
Oh, the details are the best part, which reminds me, Fireman Bob wants to ask you out.
Well, of course he does. After what you did with Fireman Eric, I'm sure we're very popular down at the station house. Tell him I'm not interested. Oh, hi, Philip. You're early.
I know. I guess I was excited to meet her. So, Alicia, right?
Yeah.
What's she like?
What's she like? Alicia, you know, I hate to make comparisons. They're often so unfair.
You want me to try?
No. Philip, I can only imagine that your Annie was an amazing woman. I just can't see how Alicia could live up to all of that.
Miss Plant, don't misunderstand. Annie had something special, in essence, a life force. I just want to see firsthand that it lives on.
Well, I'm sure that it does.
Yeah, it just went to the dark side.
All right, I'm here, and I'm starved. Did you order?
No, we haven't. Alicia Spitz? Philip Gordon?
Yeah, I figured. Waiter! Waiter. Oh, hi. I'd like to get a steak, blood rare.
Miss Spitz, you know there's no smoking in this restaurant.
Fine. Ridiculous law.
Well, smoking is bad for your heart.
What do I care? I can always get another one. Right, Philip?
Oh, I'm going to have to excuse myself. An emergency.
You're kidding?
I'm sorry. You guys have a great lunch.
So, you'd think being an animal doctor would stop your family from calling with every little medical ailment. Not my family, no. If someone's got a cough, I'm thinking hairball.
That's funny.
So, Alicia, do you have any pets?
Nope. Used to have a dog, but it got run over by a car. Oops. Sorry.
That's okay.
Good for you, Philip. Sometimes people have a tendency to take me the wrong way.
Sometimes.
You gonna finish that?
Oh, help yourself.
Hey, nice Rolex, Philly. Oh. Bet you take that baby off before you stick your hand up some hamster.
Yes, I do.
Will you excuse me? Steak's going right through me.
Well, I'm overwhelmed.
Philip, I'm so sorry.
Sorry? Oh, Miss Plant. Alicia's incredible.
I'm just surprised that you liked her.
After you left, we went for coffee. Dana, she's angry. Angry about needing a heart transplant. Resentful that everybody expects her to be grateful. But deep down, under all that hostility, she's a good person. A wonderful one.
How deep down?
Dana.
Philip, she's a horrible, horrible, horrible person.
She isn't. Once we got to actually talking, I know you'll think this is nuts, but I did see shades of my wife in her.
Philip.
Little idiosyncrasies.
Philip, your wife.
She is not dead. I know my wife is dead. Alicia is a good person.
Philip, can I tell you something? I've never told anyone this before. My grandfather loved my grandmother more than life. He used to tickle her feet. And when she died, he had the mortician sever her left foot. And he kept it. And every once in a while, he'd take it out and he'd tickle it.
That sounds a little sick.
Well, maybe it was. But it was all about love. And it was very benign. And what you're doing here, Philip, it strikes me as a little twisted.
You just don't understand.
Okay, you know what? Maybe I don't. But I've got a pretty good feel for people. And Alicia Spitz, no matter how deep down you dig, is not a nice person. What is going on, Philip?
Mom, I said I'd be there. I will. Henry, tell her. Now do you believe me? Mm-hmm. Okay. I will. I will. Love you, Mom. Bye.
But is there anything I should know?
I don't want to answer that prematurely.
But you suspect something.
Don't make that assumption, Mr. Wallace. Like my partner said, we just need more time. Can I have a word?
Excuse us.
What's going on?
Got some concerns.
What concerns? We know everything there is to know about this girl.
Roberta,
would you like some pizza?
I've been doing this a little longer than you. Just let me do my job.
She was to okay. Bed. I thought we were done here.
You thought wrong.
What was the big emergency? You left me there.
What did I miss?
He is completely infatuated with her. He wants her to be his wife so badly, and it's heartbreaking.
One thing's for sure, he's not after her money.
What are you saying?
I didn't just abandon you at lunch. You know how much I hate being screwed by clients. Don't even go there. I started thinking, what if Philip was setting us up? Knew we'd find Alicia and her money, so I checked his financials. He's legit.
Whoa, that's a lot of money for neutering puppies.
Damn straight, baby doll, and he gives a lot of it away. Look at this. He's quite the philanthropist.
Drug resistance and education, Teddy Bear Pals, Inner City Athletic League. Those are all police charities.
He likes cops.
Is that so hard to believe?
Maybe not, but it does make me wonder why.
He was grateful. After the accident that killed Mrs. Gordon, the driver of the other car fled the scene. We got a plate number and a good description from an eyewitness and managed to catch up with him a few minutes later before he got a chance to sober up. His blood alcohol was off the charts. We made a good case and the DA threw the book at him. He's doing 3 to 5 for vehicular manslaughter.
Well, I guess that's the closest thing you can get to a happy ending in a case like this.
Who was the eyewitness?
It was him, Dr. Gord.
He was driving?
Yeah.
Why do you suppose he didn't mention that to us?
Poor guy.
Yeah. Thanks, Greg. Let's go.
Can I talk to you a second?
I'll wait for you in the car.
Yeah. Look, I want to apologize for overreacting to the car fire thing.
Forget it.
Look, did you mean it when you said that you thought our relationship was a total loss?
Come on, Greg, you can't think this is working between us.
Some of it does.
Oh, you mean the physical relationship?
Maybe we should concentrate on the positive.
Greg, this is one more reason why we shouldn't be together. I cannot separate the physical from the emotional. I'm sorry.
Remind me of that.
You don't say.
My legs.
Hey! Hey! Thanks.
No problem.
You sacrificed your coffee. That was very gallant. At least let me buy you another.
Philip again?
Well, this one's from Philip. 1,000 thanks. This one's from Greg. I'm sorry.
What would the flower industry do without guilt?
Well, I'm glad Greg's guilty, but Philip, I think he thinks he's falling in love.
Well, come on, he's got to feel guilty about driving the car his wife died in, even if it wasn't his fault. I think this whole Alicia thing is his way of trying to make up for it somehow. Maybe being with that witch is his way of doing penance.
Now I feel guilty. Now he's bringing champagne.
Hello.
Hello, Philip.
Miss Plant, I have wonderful news. Alicia and I are engaged. I owe all this to both of you. You gave me the gift of Alicia. Since you introduced us, we haven't spent a moment apart.
What's it been, Philip? The whole 48 hours?
I know how this looks, Miss Plant. But since finding her, it's like I've reconnected with something I've lost.
Philip, Alicia's not Annie.
I know that. I do.
Are you doing this because you feel guilty about the accident?
What?
We know you were driving the car when Annie died, Philip. You shouldn't feel...
You have no right to tell me how to feel.
You're right. I'm sorry.
Please. I'm just asking you to be happy for me.
We are.
Look, I've got to run. I left Alicia running around town making wedding plans with my credit cards. Better not leave her out of my sight for too long. Again, mark it down. November 7th, Bel Air Hotel.
Okay, so he's sick.
Yeah, what's her excuse?
Is it at all possible she might actually love him?
You're assuming she has feelings.
You're right.
Got it. His platinum card. Last entry was 2 hours ago.
That's some healthy activity in the last 2 days. Who pays their mortgage with a credit card?
Check this out. $6,500 for lunch today. Somebody was hungry.
Miss Hall, please. You know how discreet we are about our clientele.
It's about Alicia Spitz.
What do you want to know? I hate that bitch. You know, she once almost choked on a cherry tomato. Not one person tried to help her.
We understand she made a large payment to the restaurant today using Dr. Philip Gordon's credit card.
And it was about time. Our lawyer has been demanding payment ever since she declared bankruptcy.
Manny, we gotta talk.
No, we don't.
Why are you cutting me out of the Wallace case?
I'm not cutting you out.
You met with Susan Cooper behind my back.
You followed me? What the hell is that about?
We were working this together, Manny. If you wanted to play marriage tester, why couldn't you tell me?
That's not what's happening here, Roberta. It was an accidental meet. I was playing it straight.
Really?
Really.
For me, the end of a perfect day is a drive down PCH, sunroof open, and Rod Stewart on the radio.
You're kidding. Huh? You like Rod Stewart? He's one of my top five singers of all time.
Really?
I make a lot of lists. Oh, I can't believe we've been sitting here this long.
Feels like 5 minutes to me. Hey, Susan, can I call you sometime?
Sure. I'd like that.
What are you trying to prove? That anyone given the opportunity can be unfaithful?
You're way off base here, Roberta.
The woman is vulnerable, Manny. She's confused.
So what if she is? Maybe she doesn't really want to marry the guy. Maybe I'm doing her a favor.
A favor? You're toying with this woman. You're...
Hey, back off, okay? That's not what I'm doing.
I'm wrong. You're not testing this woman. You've fallen for her.
You don't know what you're talking about.
Manny, you look me in the eye and tell me you're not making a play for this woman.
We're done here, Roberta.
You're crossing the line, Manny. It's wrong.
Excuse me, what is it exactly that you are now accusing me of?
This isn't an accusation, Alicia.
It's more of a threat.
Bankruptcy court records show you owe a lot of people a lot of money. What, you think Philip's money's gonna get you out of it?
I would like nothing more than to step on your neck, but I'm going to give you a chance to redeem yourself. Tell Philip the truth today.
What makes you think she hasn't? I know all about Alicia's financial problems, Miss Plant, and I was more than happy to help her out.
Thank you, darling.
Philip, she is using you. You want so badly for her to be Annie, she's not.
Miss Plant, this is no longer any of your business. Now, I would like you to leave.
I'm sorry. Was there something there you didn't understand?
I'm watching you.
What's he doing here?
I called him. Time to tell him the truth, Manny. It's over.
This is both our case, Roberta. You can't make that call.
I can. You gotta end it, Manny.
Look, before you say anything, I don't want to know.
We've got to...
I don't want to hear it, all right? It doesn't matter anymore. It's over. Susan came to my office today and she told me that she couldn't marry me. She said I wasn't the one, whatever that means. Look, I'll mail you a check. Thank you for your help. Oh, and by the way, you were right. I never had a chance.
Ah, this is for you. You know, what is it with you people? Every time I turn around, another complaint's lodged against you.
Well, I guess we'll just have to file this one under. Who gives a crap?
Hey, what's going on?
A Dr. Philip Gordon is threatening a restraining order against you. He claims you harassed him.
He just got engaged to an Alicia Spitz. We think she's out to scam him. I just got in her face a little bit.
Well, that I can understand. Alicia Spitz has a tendency to do that to people.
You've had previous dealings?
Her late husband drowned in the family pool a month after they were married. 56 years old, perfect health, swam every day of his life. Anyway, it was eventually ruled an accident, but we never thought so. Made her a very rich woman.
Well, she didn't stay that way.
Dr. Gordon, please. No, I don't want to leave a message. It's an emergency. What? They're in Vegas. They just eloped.
psycho around it.
He relax, we'll be in Vegas in 1 hour. He'll be fine. Yeah.
A marriage license was taken out in Vegas this afternoon in Philip Wharton's name. They're getting married at the Little Red Wedding Chapel. It's on 15th and Sahara, just off the strip.
Good work, Roberta.
I fast just full address. It'll be waiting for you on your plane.
You have a plane?
I lease it.
Fly safe.
Thanks.
You're flying the plane?
Yes.
Who are you?
Hi.
Hi.
I'm glad you called.
I'm glad you came.
Manny, there's something I should have told you before. I've been involved with someone.
I'm not surprised.
Well, now I'm not. He asked me to marry him, but I realized I didn't want to spend the rest of my life with him. I mean, I loved him. I did, but it wasn't enough. Something was missing. I guess I didn't realize that until I met you.
Look, Susan.
No, let me finish. Oh, God, I never believed in this kind of thing, but somehow I feel like something brought us together, that we were supposed to meet the other day. And I was kind of hoping you felt the same way. Please say something, because I am way out on a limb here.
Susan, I really like you.
Oh.
Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to mislead you, but the truth is, I'm seeing someone. Just can't happen right now. I really am sorry.
Well, I appreciate your honesty. I should go. I'm so glad we met.
Remember them? I wish I could forget. The woman was poison. When I asked if anyone objected to them being joined in matrimony, I was tempted to raise my own hand.
Mr. Shapiro, do you have any idea where they might be staying?
He was a nice fella. Very romantic. As I recall, she wanted to stay at one of them splashy hotels downtown, you know, but he wanted someplace more intimate, you know, something off the beaten path. I told him about the Viva Las Vegas honeymoon suites.
Great.
They got cable.
Philip? Philip? It's Glenn Hall and Dana Plant.
Miss Spitz? No.
Couldn't have.
He cut it out of her. Yes, the victim was his current wife, Alicia Spitz, but it wasn't her heart. It was his first wife's. This one's only had it about a year.
You people are from L.A., aren't you? What would this psychopath want with his first wife's heart?
We have an idea.
And it's the same blood type? Yeah, thanks, Roberta. Well,
You are right. Woda's got a 22-year-old woman at the Nevada General Hospital on the regional transplant list.
The Nevada General's 10 minutes from here.
Excuse me, Detective. We just heard over the radio some guy's holding a doctor hostage at Nevada General.
Just hold your positions.
The surgeon's name is Dr. William Fletcher. He's chief of cardiac surgery.
Go! Stay where you are!
Glenn, he doesn't want to hurt anyone. Dana, he just cut a woman's heart out.
Please go away, Miss Plant. I didn't want you to be a part of this. That's why I filed that complaint.
Well, Philip, we are a part of this now.
Then help. There's a woman in this hospital waiting for a heart. I want them to use Annie's.
Sir, we just can't do that. We don't know anything about this organ.
I already told you! It's strong and healthy! The women are the same blood type! Now, you are wasting time. It's only got another hour of viability.
Dr. Fletcher, if it makes a difference, this man is a surgeon.
I'm sorry. We just can't accept a heart off the street.
Well, yes, you can. I am the woman's next of kin. In my pocket is a marriage certificate and a signed legal consent for this donation.
Philip, please just put the gun down.
I just couldn't bear the idea of Annie's heart living inside that woman's plant. I wanted to love Alicia. I tried. But she was evil. She didn't deserve Annie's heart. But somebody does.
Philip, there's nothing they can do to bring Annie back. You know that.
She's really gone.
Philip, you just have to find a way to move on.
I wish I could do that. But I can't.
She had a 914.
We did what we could.
So that's it? It's over for you? You just forget about it and move on?
Yeah. You move on. Look, Dana. Some cases take a piece of you with them. You just have to decide how much you're willing to give.
I guess I don't find it so easy to walk away.
Good night.
If I listen long enough to you, I'd find a way to believe that it's all true. Knowing that you lied straight-faced while I cried, still I look to find a reason to believe.
Look, I know I screwed up, so please spare me the lecture, huh?
Fine. So, Manny, what is it? Why her?
I don't know.
The way I see it, you can go one of two ways with this. One, you'll never feel this way about anyone ever again. And two, Now that you know what it feels like, the next time, and there will be a next time, you'll know what it is when it comes around. I'll see you tomorrow.
Somebody else, someone like you, makes it easy to give. Never think about myself. If I gave you time to change my mind, I'd find a way just to leave the past behind.
Dana?
Yeah, I'm in here.
You the only one here?
Yeah.
I heard about what happened. Sorry. You okay?
I guess.
Figured I'd ask that up front this time.
Noted. Greg, when we were together, had you ever felt that way about anyone before?
Is this a trick question?
No. I was just wondering if you ever felt that, you know, maybe I was the one.
Well, I don't know. I mean, did you ever feel that way about me?
Wait. What's going on?
What we felt for each other may have just been physical, and a physical thing is all right, right?
You can do that.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Next on Snoops.
You should take this seriously. I think you have a stalker.
I need you to find my birth mother.
She wants to find her birth mother.
Well, that's not her choice.
A woman doesn't have a choice,
you
know?
She's a girl. She sleeps with beanie babies.
I feel that I don't know where I am from. And I can't sleep. I can't sleep. I just want to know who she is.
This cannot be a happy reunion.
He's here.
What?
Dana. Hello, Dana.
Quit talking to me like a cop. Just be my boyfriend for a minute.
Boyfriend isn't as calm about this as the cop is.
This isn't the flu.
He's 158 over 96, and he's having some PVCs.
Greg's been staying at your house a lot, right?
All right.
What if it was meant for you?
You stink.
When you have TV's hottest couple,
baby, I love you,
and the best show of the new season, you're covered. They just fallen in love, and nothing else matters. Except kids, home, exes, and everything in between.
You're destroying my reputation.
I hope so.
Celia Ward and Billy Campbell in the provocative, sexy new drama, Once and Again, ABC Tuesday, 10, 9 Central.